stands. Goal coming in the third minute of the game from Tony Polster. 1-0 to the Austrians. These Germans playing their fifth qualifying match of eight in this competition. And their record so far, one victory and three defeats. With those at home to the Turks. As you've just seen before this match coverage began. They were fairly ripped asunder on that occasion. And it wasn't terribly clever defending in this match either. And Polster got in for the goal. Forward for Tome, who's trying his luck on the right flank. Tumbling down to that challenge from Petchel, but it seemed he'd made his mind up that he was going to be fouled before the challenge came in. Half an hour of the contest has gone, a quarter of an hour to break. Austria leading East Germany by a goal to nil. Kick off Weber's head. Sammer. Lüttner. It's Russ to clear it to Prohaska. A chance for a run on here from Polster. This inside wasn't particularly good. Control, and he was in a similar position to the one in which he'd scored that opening goal, appreciating the pass from Rodax, but his control let him down at the final moment. Very deep, isn't he? Played forward for Kirsten. And Kirsten was definitely fouled there. Quite blatant foul there on Ulf Kirsten. So the Belgian referee could be happy with the scent. By Summer. asked for a four-man role. In the end, they're organising their part. Part of you is Kevin Taylor, the captain. Sending it high over Lindenberger's crossbar. Attacking full back, but Russ. Seen too much of young Andy Herzog. Been among the goals in recent matches for Austria. A couple against Turkey in the 3-2 victory in Vienna in November. the World Cup match. So he also got the equaliser in the friendly in Graz. The last match, the Austrian last match, which eventually ended 2-1 in the Czech Slovak score. Zama. Actually get the touch. Well, he was in close attendance. Jack Lindner said it was and went over the bar. That, but he won't keep it in play. Tony Polster got the opening goal. And at the end of the half, he's proving just as much of a thorn. Germans. Added time at the end of the first half. A little of that, but not over much. Stupak. Well blocked. Weber. And he was indicating to the referee that we're into injury time. Kirsten, the corner, headed away. Whistle to end the half after this 28 seconds. Half-time in Leipzig looking like this. East Germany 0, Austria 1. We return for more World Cup highlights on the other side of this break. Welcome back to the Central Stadium in Leipzig. The East Germans, after a disappointing first half, have made a substitution at the break. They sent on Thomas Doll of Dynamo Berlin. He's a striker in place of Dresden's Andreas Trautmann. That's interesting because it'll mean a bit of a reshuffle in the rear guard. You see already that the man who'd been operating on the right side of the defence, Matthias Lindner, has moved in to partner Jörg Stahmann on the East German defence. That's the new man, Thomas Doll. He's the scorer for the 10-time East German champions, Dynamo Berlin, or Berliner SC as they're known in Germany. They had won the East German title 10 times back-to-back until this season, when Dynamo Dresden, their big rivals, wrested it from them. Pick the Austrians, head up Weber, the captain. Hodak's beaten in the air. Very good shot, which might have troubled Klaus Lindenberger had he been able to direct it slightly lower and under the goal. good off the ball running here to split those two defenders and rifle the shot, and he didn't really get it around onto the target, but he found a very good position. German football, and he certainly showed it there. A good curving run in between the defenders. They're still held up while Peter Hartmann receives the treatment from Anton Kulowitz, the Austrian muscle. Also with him, carrying the bottle, Austrian team doctor Oswald Schwinger. Obviously happy that Arthur, who is in a little pain, can continue. Resumes with a goal kick for the Austrians. Evening draws on a pace in Leipzig. Germany's problem, but for all the possession they've had and all the pressure they've attempted to create, when they've finally got to stepping up a gear as they approach the goal, their first touch have let them down, and the Austrian defence, which has been very well marshalled, has been able to snap shot. That's the collision that's left the two players on the deck. Robert Petschel is down, the Austrian. and Matthias Sammer of East Germany. Just a chance to remind you what you can see next week on Eurosport, that European Cup final between AC Milan and Steaua Bucharest in the new Camp Stadium in Barcelona is on 4200 UK time, 2300 Central European time. And the night before from World Cup Group 5, which includes Scotland, France and Yugoslavia, it's Norway against Cyprus. That at the same time, 2200 UK, 2300 Central European. On Tuesday night, the night before the European Cup final. Both of those, as is the case with this match, on Eurosport. We are watching East Germany against Austria. Score still 1-0 in Austria's favour, and we're in the 10th minute of the second half.
Enough to win a match if it's in Eurocup.